What's up, people? Varun here. So this here is LG Gram 2020 in a nice little white box. So this is the 14-inch version, which was released in Q1 2020. And let's quickly unbox this and find out how the laptop is, and then we'll jump to the review. Alright, so let's open the lid, and here it is. So this, I think, is the power cord. This is your normal power cord. This is the charger. And this is the Ethernet jack. Let's pull this out. This is the laptop. Anything else in the box? Yep, some paperwork. And yep, that's it. Nothing else is in the box. So a pretty simple packaging for LG Gram 2020. Let me remove the plastic quickly. Well, yep, very, very light, and it is built amazingly well. I mean, the construction is pretty professional. All right, so yeah, in the box you get the laptop, paperwork, and the charger. That's it. This is your unboxing experience for LG Gram 2020.
Hey guys, so today we are taking a look at this feather of a laptop. This here is LG Gram 14 2020 version. The exact model number is 14Z90N. To be honest, when I held this for the first time, I thought it was a dummy laptop. It just doesn't have the weight of any traditional laptop, and your brain has to adjust and realize that you're holding a full-blown laptop. The Gram 14 guts are made out of Intel Core i5-1035 G7 processor with 8GB of DDR4 RAM and 512GB of NVMe M.2 SSD. There is no dedicated graphics chipset on this machine, which is a shame. But it does have Intel Iris integrated graphics. Maybe they eliminated the dedicated graphics as they wanted to keep its weight below 1kg. At 999 grams, it is the lightest 14-inch laptop you can buy right now. Even Dell XPS 13 weighs more than this. Does it command its hefty price tag? Let's find out. As soon as you open the laptop, you are greeted with a beautiful 16:9 display, which is bright and glossy. The sRGB color gamut is 96% and the nits count is 300. The 14-inch screen with full HD 1920x1080p IPS display delivers precise and clear imagery through good color accuracy without any distortion at any angle. Though I have no complaints with the display, at this price point it should come with a panel with a higher resolution and a minimum of 350 nits of brightness. One additional thing is that LG doesn't use PWM to adjust its brightness levels. That means you can use this laptop for long periods of time without any eye strain. Overall, I am satisfied with the display, and I wish LG can give us a higher resolution and 16:10 aspect ratio panel for its 14-inch model in the future. Now, let's jump to the performance, and unfortunately, I have bad news here. The Core i5-1035G7, although a great processor, does not perform to its full capability in this chassis. Why, if you ask me? It's because there is no active cooling in this laptop, folks. When the CPU is taxed too heavily, it's forced to throttle down to a lower clock speed so it doesn't overheat. And the result is crappy performance across the board. I mean, for normal usage, this laptop works just fine. But if there is heavy load, then the performance feels choppy. You don't expect this to happen on a laptop which costs almost a lakh of rupees. During your day-to-day, when you have several Chrome tabs open and running some other apps in the background, you can feel that the upper part of the keyboard gets really warm, thanks to no active cooling. I tried video editing on this machine and the experience was not great at all. With such disappointing processor performance, SSD more than makes up for it with good read and write speeds. Now, let's talk about its build quality and design. No doubt, LG Gram is a classy looking machine, but it leaves a lot to be desired, especially when you compare it with other ultrabooks in its category and especially when you consider what you paid for this laptop. The overall build quality is sturdy and the lid's hinge can be lifted smoothly with a single finger. The lid is particularly flimsy. It can be wobbled around like a piece of cardboard. Then again, you can't expect the LG Gram 14 to be rock solid when it weighs less than a kilogram. The full metal body made from magnesium alloy, which is used as aircraft material, is lightweight and super strong. Its durability is clarified by passing the demanding military standard of durability and reliability that checks 7 factors from shock and dust to extreme temperatures as claimed by LG. Although the Gram 14 does look sleek from almost every angle, the bezels surrounding the 14-inch display are a bit chunky, especially when you compare it with rival machines like Dell XPS 13 and Samsung Galaxy Book. LG's logo sits below the display and the forehead bezel houses a 720p webcam, which is mediocre. The bottom part of the laptop is comprised of 5 rubberized feet that prevents the laptop from sliding around. The overall build and design leaves you wanting for more, and if you're looking for more striking and futuristic design, then you should look elsewhere. Oh, and while I was reviewing the laptop, the Gram branding from the lid came off. Shocking. If we talk about gaming, then the news is not great either. Since there is no dedicated GPU on this machine, this is not made for gaming. But I still tried Fortnite, and even on low settings, the frame rates were not really high. It's definitely playable, but the experience won't be great. If there is one thing where this laptop shines, is its battery life. With 72 watt hours of power underneath, this laptop will easily last you for a day and more. Its standby time is also great. The only gripe here is charging speed. A full charge takes more than 3 hours, which is excruciatingly slow in 2020. The plus side is you can charge this laptop via the USB-C port as well. Now comes the keyboard and touchpad. The keyboard is backlit with chiclet style keys. There's not too much travel and it's fairly quiet too. Typing on this keyboard is a real treat. Underneath the keyboard, there's the touchpad. No complaints here as well. It's not made of glass, but fingers glide smoothly and it supports Windows gestures really well. The power button, which is the upper rightmost key, doubles up as a fingerprint reader. It's reliable and unlocks the laptop instantly every time. Let's jump to the port selection. On the left, you have the charge port, USB Type-A 3.2 Gen 1 port, HDMI port, and a USB Type-C plus Thunderbolt 3 port. On the right, you have Kensington lock slot, another USB Type-A 3.2 Gen 1 port, audio jack, and a micro SD card reader. The speakers are bottom firing and they are average at best. And in terms of upgradability, there is good news as well. You have the option of upgrading the RAM to up to 24 GB. Alright, time for final thoughts. No doubt LG Gram 14 is an amazing device. Its super light profile makes it the lightest 14-inch laptop on the planet. The display is good and the port selection is aplenty. And no one can compete this laptop in terms of battery life. You can carry it around easily and it's a good choice for those who are always on the move. But the below average processor and thermal performance is hard to ignore. If you are paying close to a lakh of rupees, then you would expect the laptop to fire from all cylinders, and that is not the case here. I suspect LG had to tone down the performance of the processor in order to meet the low weight goals and limited cooling potential. Overall, this is still an appealing unit, but if you are looking to get more out of the CPU and GPU, then you should look elsewhere. I'd take extra grams any day for a better CPU, GPU, and thermal performance. If you want to spend a lakh of rupees on a laptop, then there are better options out there. Alright guys, this is it for the review. Let's hang out in the comment section below and you can fire all your questions regarding the LG Gram 14 2020. And yes, please like and subscribe as it helps out the channel, and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.